evening, good morning, all my lovely people over here on Kick. So this morning I'm doing something a little bit different. I know it's early, but I figured I better jump on this shit right away. Yeah, Kubara, what up? Or Kubara, what's up, man? Hold on, y'all, be right back. Give us 1 second. So y'all come on in, hang out, have some time. I'll be right back. Go ahead and come on in, man. Y'all just get in, get some, hang on. Hey, what's up, everybody? I am back. I helped the family out with something real quick. But we are back. What is up? How's everybody doing? Oh, to anybody out there that thinks they're going to steal the music that I create, just know that I have every single stream on backup. So if you try to take my music, William Glory Hole, I can easily take these videos and show them to the proper people. Okay? Yo, Raven, what up, dude? Raven the Player, welcome to the stream, man. Welcome, 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 dude. Anyway, let's go. So today I'm doing something a little bit different that I have not done in like years. And I started doing this when I first started out with music production. Like when I first started out using FL Studios, like I think I started doing it like literally the, I want to say fifth week when I very first started using FL Studios, back when FL Studios was FL Studios, I want to say 12. It was either 10 or 12. I believe it was 12. But they were just adding in some really cool stuff and whatnot, and I was getting used to it, getting my feet wet on how to use FL Studios properly, which don't get me wrong, I fucking love FL Studios, it's fucking amazing. That's the one that I use literally daily. Like, I use this shit for everything from EDM tracks, remix tracks, you name it. But for this one, we're going to go in here to Sawyer, and we are going to be making a beat and or instrumental out of just sounds with no drums. It's going to literally be no drums. It's just going to be all sound. I know it sounds weird to make an instrumental without a drum kit, but I think you guys might like this idea. And I challenge any music producer out there or beat maker to do the same thing. Just to kind of, you know, extend your stuff a little bit. So let's go in here to, what the hell is synthesizer? Sound like a Chinese fucking guitar. Oh. That's an interesting one. Almost sounds like some like low feedback from a guitar, not gonna lie. Oh, there we go. Let's go down the list here. I'm definitely using that for something. I don't know what yet, but I am using that for something. Oh. Trying to find that right sound that would actually work. Oh man, I'm not seeing that. Yeah, I think Cyber Falcon is going to be the way to go for this one. Let's cut the detune off. Oh, there we go. Alright, so we have our tone. Yo, Dr. Mario, what's up? Now let's run that to there. Oh, absolutely, dude. Absolutely, I am. Fucking love cyberpunk and industrial music. Alright, so let's put that on track 1. put this one on track here because we are going to do something insane with this. Track 2. Put Sire on track 1. Let's put this on track 2. Now, let's go for one of my personal favorite ones, which is Toxic Biohazard. I fucking love Toxic. Dude, Toxic Biohazard has some of the most unique sounds, honestly, out of the stock plugins. And that right there is why. Now let's put this on track 2. I want this to be just a little bit louder than the drum kit on that. While the... Alright, let's switch on the sound really quickly. Ooh, hold up, hold up. Alright, so I do need to move this back just a tad bit here. Let's see where this whole thing is sitting at. 121, okay. So I kind of went a little bit past. Alright, now we have this going. I just kind of mess around and see what I come out with. Just to be funny, let's see what it sounds like on, let's see what it sounds like on 86. Oh! Yo, that sounds dope! That actually sounds cool as fuck. Yo, that sounds so sick. Not gonna lie, that shit sounds sick. Wait, did I put that on number two? Then let's go with poison. I have not used poison in a long time. Plus I also did hear they have some new updates. Damn, they do have some new sounds over here. Oh, hell yeah. Trying this all the way down. Okay. Oh no, I don't need to worry about that, okay. Alright, that is all just by a slight bit. Oh, there we go, there we go. Just changed it up a lot. Now let's go to another one of my personal favorites, morphine. Kids, don't do drugs. Just saying. Thank you. Alright, so there's some sort of weird knocking in here. I need to figure out which one it is. So now that we got that knocked out, let's check out transistor base. Turn it down and switch it out. Holy shit! That is a lot of presets. Sounds like a malfunctioning computer, I'm not gonna lie. Let's see if we can find a sequencer in this thing. So I'm going to get rid of this. Alright, Oh, there we go, there we go. That is perfect. So, what do you guys think so far, man? On a scale of 1 to 10, what do you think? Like I said, there are no drum tracks in this. It's literally just all sound. So, rate this on a scale of 1 to 10, man. What do you guys think? I may just name it that. I just may name an album that, Toilet Music. Just for shits and giggles. I said this is just me messing around with literally just sounds. Like there are no drum kits in this. It's literally just all sound. Alright, here's what it sounds like on 130. Now, if this don't prove that I know how to do music without what everybody else, all the bullshit talkers are saying, here's your proof. Literally, here's your fucking proof. Scale this up real quick. All But you guys literally sat right here and watched me create it. Like, dead ass. Y'all sat right here and watched me make this shit. Nameless Night City. Wham, bam, done. Let that shit render, and then this is where the magic happens. This is where the fun part for remixing songs begins. Well, starts to begin. Alright, so now that we're done with that, let's exit out of here. Let's go over here to Rupture. Let's go tunes to tube. And let's upload this bitch. And then I'm going to take it, and then I'm going, that's when the magic is going to happen. So you have to then go here, and then go here. And so we got the music. Now we just need to get the image. Which would be that. That looks good. Hey, True Video Man, how you doing this morning, man? How is the Yola doing this morning, man? Alright, so once this processing is done, copy, then let's go rave.dj. Alright, so question, what band or artist would you guys like to see me collab that with? What artist would you like to see me remix that track to? Like, it can be any band you want, man. It can be Skrillex, Linkin Park, Korn, whatever you guys want. Oh, there we go. Now, just to be funny, let's go for an NF acapella, man. Now let's go for... Let's try Paralyzed. Now, just sit back and let the magic happen. It's gonna take a minute. So, while we are at it, no way, somebody literally did a Far From Home Plankton AI remix, bro, that's sick. Oh no. This is either gonna be really cringy or really interesting.
Another day in this carnival of souls. Another night settles in as quickly as it goes. The memories are shadows.
Surprisingly not bad. I've heard worse. This actually isn't too bad. Alright, just from that little bit, that's actually not bad. I'm not gonna lie, that's actually pretty sick.
You know, it literally just happened one day. We were practicing.
Check this out.
Oh, 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 stay out of the kitchen!
Now, if anybody wants to know how the whole thing was disturbed out, then check this shit out.
Check this out.
Not this.
You know, it literally just happened one day. We were practicing, and, you know, that beat that Mike starts the song off with is just very primal and tribal, and it makes you kind of go to an animalistic sort of place, and there used to just be a pause. We used to pause for traumatic impact, and there was nothing. And one practice, I just went.
Oh, wow!
And they all kind of stopped.
What the hell was that?
You know, it literally just happened one day. We were practicing, and you know that beat that Mike starts the song off with is just very primal and tribal, and it makes you kind of go to an animalistic sort of place, and there used to just be a pause. We used to pause for dramatic impact, and there was nothing. And one practice that just went.
Let's see if I can find it here. Ah, here we go.
Down with the sickness, the wah-ah-ah-ah noise was inspired by a visit to the Chicago Zoo.
No.
There's like these pictures of like monkeys making crazy noises or whatever. Who the f*** comes up with this shit? I swear to God. Okay, so was it just...
It literally just happened one day. We were practicing and... You know, that beat that Mike starts the song off with is just very primal and tribal, and it makes you kind of go to an animalistic sort of place. And there used to just be a pause. We used to pause for dramatic impact, and there was nothing. And one practice that just went. And they all kind of stopped. They're like, "What the hell is that?" And I'm like, "You know, I don't know, but there's something to it. Just humor me. Let's do it again." And a couple more times it started sticking with them, and lo and behold, now I'm sure that's what's going to be on my goddamn tombstone. Here lies David Grayman.
I go, who can really say they invented a noise? Well, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, I'll take it.
Yeah, inspired by this man himself, not an animal, the Chicago.
I'm my own animal. Thank you very much.
There you go.
Now y'all know how that sound came about. Now you guys know how that sound came about. Pretty interesting, ain't it? Oh, this thing's taking forever.
Time you saved a turtle. That day you led the charge.
A few months ago, we had this really... heartbreaking revelation from Disturbed frontman David Draymond, where he revealed on stage that he was in a very bad place earlier this year, and he considered joining Chester and Chris Cornell, and he was going through a lot. Apparently he had lost his dog, apparently he had the end of his marriage, and he was just sort of sitting in this empty house, and now he's sort of expounded upon that. And first of all, I just want to commend him, because the most important thing to take away from this is that what he's saying, I know somebody out here watching this, anybody who's watching the interviews he's done, what anyone at his shows, his fans that listen, probably relate to that and have been through hard times and have felt what he's felt. And you can tell how sincere he's being in this. And I've always admired the massive career that Disturbed has built. And I think that it's so courageous for him to kind of share his true feelings on this. And now he's talking about the frustration when he was at his lowest point, and he was, and I also want to shout one other thing out with David Draymond. By the way, it's not just that he had the courage of talking about going through this. What a fitness transformation this guy has done. He has dropped 30-something pounds. You got to give the guy a round of applause, because he was at his lowest earlier this year, and he turned it around on multiple fronts. He has dropped some serious weight and has really been putting in the work on you know, the dude looks jacked. And so I just wanted to say that too, because you got to root for people that are getting in shape and all that stuff. That's something I'm always trying to do, and I just love to see when when people are able to do that. But he spoke to the charismatic voice about how hard it was. So apparently when David was at his lowest and he was trying to get that help that he needed, he's saying it was laughably bad. So apparently when David was at that point and he was trying to get the assistance that he needed, which obviously is so important, he was stonewalled at every turn, even with someone like him with his resources and I'm sure probably his wealth. Even he couldn't find anywhere to get assistance and he couldn't find anyone to talk to. Everyone's booked up, and that's the thing, is that there seems to be so much despair going on in the world right now, and it's just becoming really difficult for people to, you know, mental health services are just very much lacking in this country, and that is heartbreaking. And so he talked to the charismatic voice, and I just commend him because he's helping a lot of people talking about this. He says, people classically have viewed it as a weakness. Now, why can't you use logic and reason and the beauty that you're surrounded by in your life to dispel what's happening to you? It's because it's not under your control. Logic and reason don't respond to it. You can make all the sense in the world. What's happening to you doesn't make sense. It's no different. And I've said this on numerous occasions, and it couldn't be more true. It's no different than cancer. You don't have control over cancer. It eats away at you from the inside. It metastasizes, if you allow it. And you can't be blamed for depression or addiction, even, for that matter. And any more than you can contracting cancer or some other debilitating disease. You don't want it. You're not asking for me. You're not too weak, and that's why you succumb to it. It's out of your control. So he said that he wasn't able to find a therapist. He wasn't able to find any in-network coverage, and saying that most of them don't even take insurance. He said, my biggest critique of the status quo is that we don't have enough support. A phone number isn't enough. It's not. For many, it takes a tremendous amount of courage to go ahead and dial that number in the first place. And let's say that you're in a position like I am. What am I going to do? Call an 800 number? I can't do that. So finding help when you finally get to the point that you're crying out for it should be easier to get. I couldn't agree with that more. He said, when I was at my low point about 3 months ago, and I had just said goodbye to my dog of 14 years, my best friend, which, that's heartbreaking. Sometimes losing pets is very tough. He says, I'm in this house that I got specifically because I had the dog, 110-pound male dog, my Gabriel, my guardian angel, and now I'm in this house all alone, and my son isn't with me, and I'm divorced, and I'm not feeling well, and everywhere I look, I see my dog. Everything reminds me of him. I reached out and I tried to get help, and it was unfucking believably frustrating. Everybody's unavailable. Nobody's taking your patients. They want you to do this evaluation, that evaluation. Do you have the money for it? Can you qualify for it? Is it in your insurance plan? Fuck you. Enough. I'm telling you. You get to the point where you're vulnerable enough that you're desperate enough and you need help. Fucking help me. I ended up going to one therapist, and she ended up telling me she didn't have enough time to cure me and pawns me off to three other therapists that didn't have enough time to cure me. It shouldn't be that hard. It shouldn't be that hard. It shouldn't be as much of a business as it is, as he said. He goes on, we need to be way more proactive about mental health in this country, in this world, in the society that we live in. It shouldn't be so much easier, and it's not. I mean, thank God for my son. Thank God for good people that I have around me. Thank God for my fans and my band and the performances, because without them, I don't know if I could have gotten through. And some of the things that saved me every day are some of the things that led to the demise of my colleagues. The pressure, being under the microscope, having every note, every word, every moment, every behavior analyzed, and the expectations that come with it, that once you achieve a certain level, that's what they expect from you every single night. And not being able to hit those notes that they're dying to hear from you is demoralizing in a way I can't even explain. When you become the key to unlock the door and you can't unlock it yourself anymore, it's a terrifying status quo to live in. For too many of my colleagues, it exacerbated their already severe depression. It's just so great to see him on the right track there, where he is obviously going through so much and he's fighting through that. And I know that him talking about this is going to help so many people out there that listen to their music, and his music has already helped so many people, but this is just really next level here, him speaking so candidly, because there is a shortage. It is too much like a business. It is something that needs to be fixed in this country. And on top of that, he didn't just rely on that aspect. He also did something about his health and wellness and he is getting physically fit and all of that. And so it's just, this is a very, very empowering and encouraging thing to see from David Draymond, where he's not just helping himself. I do think that he's going to be doing a great deal of help to his fans, and that's so important. And so it's just, you know, my heart goes out to him. It really does. And it is great to see him sort of setting such a great example for the fans out there. And I know that it's a difficult time for a lot of people right now. And there are a lot of people that are hurting in this country, and it's, you know, it's tough. And so it's just, it's courageous for him to share that. So shout out to David Draymond. And so folks, that is all for now. If you like this video, you can subscribe to Rock Feed.
He's definitely right, dude. Like, there is a lot going on in this country that no one is truly, you know, speaking on. Let's see how this music turns out, y'all. Yeah, I know. Yeah, I know. But anyways, guys, hopefully y'all did enjoy that, man. If you guys did enjoy this whole stream, man, y'all already know what to do, and I will catch you guys later on today. With that being said, I'm fucking with you guys, and I'm out of here, y'all. Also, be on the lookout for my remix channel coming very, very, very soon on YouTube and other platforms. So, yeah. I will have more details on my later, man. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Y'all already know what to do. And I'll catch you guys later on, man. Hope you guys have a good morning. Have a safe drive to work, wherever you guys are at. And I'll catch you guys later, man. Peace.